Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Queue Silliness on the channel. Today, I'm going to be playing as Falstad, and on our team today, I think there's a couple stacks in both teams, but I wasn't really paying attention. On our team today, it's going to be a Anubarak, Tyrone, Dahaka, Murky, and Falstad going up against Kel'Thuzad, whose avatar picture still looks really stretched out and ridiculous. Arthas, the Butcher, Abathur, and Nova. So the build I'm going to be doing today is a very different build for Falstad. It's one that I've seen before, but I've never actually tried out. And I am excited to, because normally I do AA builds or right-click builds or auto-attack builds, whatever you want to call it, for Falstad. He is pretty much crowned king as far as the ranged assassin goes for AA builds. I mean, he does so much damage with the combined strength of his basic attacks, along with, of course, he has secret weapon, and he also has lightning rod. That all equates to just doing a lot of damage in a very short amount of time. And it's almost, you can't get away from him because of the way that barrel roll works. But this build today that I'm going to be doing is going to be a very, very different build here. It's going to heavily emphasize Lightning Rod, which is his W ability, which is going to more emphasize on getting the unavoidable damage out there. That is his W ability, as we were able to get a quick kill on Kel'Thuzad there. Instead of him having to stay in range for a basic attack or anything like that, we simply just want to use our Lightning Rod ability to just do tons of damage, but from afar, staying safe. There we go, getting tons of damage there. The enemy team losing three people very quickly. So good job by our team here. So level one, I did go for Wingman. Now, Wingman might seem like a very peculiar pickup here. And the reason why I say that is because you might be saying to yourself, Samitha, why in the world would you pick Bribe? Or a bribe-ish type ability when Falstad is not, he's not murky, like you're not playing a specialist here. Well, the thing about Wingman is, and this is something I actually did not know for a very long time, but Wingman actually empowers Lightning Rod, the W, your W ability. So what that basically means is that you can help your team out by getting stacks of bribe as well as getting mercenary camps, but also you're going to complement your burst damage with Lightning Rod, and that's the whole gist of this build. So overall, I do think that the sustained DPS is much, much, much better for an auto attack build. However, I do think that the Lightning Rod build is a little bit better off for team fights, probably, especially. Almost got killed there by the by the Toxic Nest. I saw that Locust coming out of nowhere. I figured Abathur was around there. A good placement there with the Toxic Nest by the Abathur player. Almost ran me right into my death. Level 4 here is when the start was when the magic happens. Level 4 gonna go for Static Shield. Basically, he's gonna gain 4% of his maximum HP every 4 seconds while Lightning Rod is active and hitting something. I think it has to hit something. Yeah, after every strike. There you go. I'm not gonna use the flight movement speed and movement command right now because we really just don't need it. That's not the real Nova. Fair enough. I'm going to keep the real Nova honest, however. I do have one stack of Bribe up already. By the way, I'm going to call it Bribe. I know that it's called Wingman, but I'm going to call it Bribe. You're just going to have to deal with it. Fortunately, we do not have Lightning Rod up yet, and I do not want to get stopped here by Arthas. I am going to keep myself in range, however, if Arthas is able to do tons of damage there. But yeah, I also have the Falstad announcer enabled too, if you didn't already know that, or didn't notice it anyway. But yeah, that's really, I think that that's really, really neat, is just the fact that you can use, it's a clever way to incentivize a ranged assassin to stick with, to help out his team and be a little bit more of a team player rather than a greedy assassin who, I'm just a hard carry. Well, with Falstad, you can actually do a little bit of both, because not only are you getting the damage bonus from the Wingman talent, but also, you're helping out your team getting the mercenary camps and just making it overall easy. I think that you only get help from the Wingman talent if you take a mercenary, not if you use, like, say, Lightning Rod, like every, I don't know what I'm trying to say here. Just don't listen to me. Sorry, I'm looking over. Apparently Dan is having another baby. Congrats to Dan. Dan Giesling, that is. This is what we need, another Dan in the world. Dan's Instagram is a riot, by the way. Alright, no, is Instagram or Snapchat? I don't know. I don't pay attention to social media. Never have, never will. But I know somebody who does go to Dan's, I think it actually is Snapchat, all the time, and man, his Dan leads a leads a crazy life. I'm gonna go ahead and fly down here to the bot lane and help out. There we go. So I'm gonna stay on top of the Butcher here. Unfortunately, we're not able to get the stun from the Lunar Flare. Tyrone. That's one thing I love about Falsad is just his amazing ability to just do so much damage from it, from range, and then of course you have the added effect of having that shield come out from the static shield as well. This all equates to just big time damage in a very short amount of time. Of course, he also has one of the better poke harasses in the game with his Q ability. The Hammerang is just so scary. If you get hit by the bounce and back, you're not gonna have a good time. But we're able to take down the two mercenaries there, and you did see I do have a 10% damage bonus to Lightning Rod now, which you can use on buildings, by the way, in case you did not know. There we go, just like that. Level 10, here we go. Level 10, gonna be going for Mighty Gust. Now, Mighty Gust is not a talent that I usually take on Falstad, mostly due to the fact that I just don't like to play Falstad all that much, but I don't really have a good reason why I shouldn't be playing Falstad. Like, Falstad has everything that I like in a good ranged assassin. He's fast, he does tons of damage, he's got a really strong presence, and he can disrupt the enemy team during a team fight with Mighty Gust instead of, like, say, Hinterland's Blast. I am going to use Flight here as soon as I get my mana up. Waiting for Falstad to take off here, which he should be doing right about now. Yep. Heading on over. So it's 11-2 so far, as the whole theme of this past week and a half now has been Team Solo Q, Midsilius, 9, LMQ, Copenhagen Wolves, Toys R Us, Have Your Way, Toasty Quiznos, FBI, yada yada station, investigation station, has been just absolutely wrecking shop on the enemy teams as of late. I'm not exactly sure what's going on with that, but I like it. Nice drag there by Dehaka. The enemy team knows that they are not going to be able to fight with us, not without having their level 10s at least. We're going to get another free Punisher here. Now, unfortunately, I do not gain stacks of Bribe from going after the altars, or going after the map objective mobs. We have unleashed a frozen Punisher upon our enemy. Hopefully a new Barak helps me out a little bit. If not, then we're going to have to wait for another stack, because I don't feel like going back. Although I will go behind Nova and the Butcher and the rest of the team here, see if I can get a Mighty Gust off and blow them back this way. Oh, I got stunned by the Butcher. I was able to get them anyway. I'm gonna use the static shield here to give myself a shield to stop me from dying to Nova. I thought for sure that I was gonna be able to get Butcher, but no, he was able to get the onslaught charge out on me right before I got the Mighty Gust off. It still worked anyway because we ended up getting the kills there. But in all fairness, I should have died right there. I'm glad I didn't, however. And again, if you find yourself in that same exact scenario, but you have a target to use Lightning Rod on, you can create yourself a little bit of a damage shield if you need to in a huge emergency like we just had. Level 13 gonna be going for Thunderstrikes, which is going to increase the amount of damage done every consecutive strike on the same target with Lightning Rod, and that is where the magic really starts to happen. It's sort of scary to see two Kel'Thuzads on the screen. That's not going to work, Kel'Thuzad. Yeah, so Thunderstrikes, basically 20% more damage each subsequent strike, and that is where that's where the magic lies for Falstad. Hopefully I can get a little bit of help over here. If not, I can just deal with it, I suppose. There you go, thank you, Tyrone. No. I almost flew about 3 feet in the air because I'm so used to it. It's a muscle reflex for me to hit my Z key whenever I'm done doing something in Here's the Storm. That's one of the weirder chains I think I've ever seen. Able to get the Butcher there with that Mighty Gust. I'm going to keep the static shield up for me here, and the Butcher's not going to be able to catch up to me. I'm not sure where Nova is. Against my better judgment, I'm going to stay in here and try to fight this. Here we go. I'm going to use the lightning rod here to get the strikes here on Arthas, and doing so much damage. Look at the damage from Hammerang. Arthas is going to get taken out. Thank you to the heal. I think Taranda did actually heal me there. I got to be careful, Nova. I do see her down in the bottom. right next to Dehaka. Now she's moving behind the tower here. Good drag by Dehaka. Beautiful job there by our team. It was a nasty engagement that, admittedly, I started. However, with the level difference that we had, I was pretty sure we're going to be okay. It got a little bit scary towards the end there. Good job there using the bro charge of Dehaka to get away from the charge from the butcher. There you go. I'm just going to keep Lightning Rod just walking right with the butcher. I mean, you can't get away from it. Dehaka needs to be careful, however, because he can get sniped here by Nova. After 10 minutes now, 18-3. Man, oh man. No problem. Mighty Gust, a lot of fun. But like I said, this is a fun build to try for those of you who might be a little bit sick of the regular run-of-the-mill auto attack builds for Falstad. The Ride the Lightning build is quite a lot of fun to play if you can pull it off. Now, I will say that one of my favorite talents, of course, is Static Shield, if you couldn't tell from me just talking about it nonstop. I like the idea of getting a shield when I deal damage. That sort of thing, that kind of utility is very, very, very good for someone as strong as Falstad. Level 16, by the way, I did go for Airy Gust, which is basically going to give me a little bit of increased movement speed, and we don't have to worry about the Tailwind delay taking so long to kick in. Good job by our team there, getting the advantage on Kel'Thuzad. Of course, I do have Mighty Gust. If I can get behind Butcher here, I will try to blow him into our team. I was able to get the Mighty Gust on him. Unfortunately, though, I think the rest of my team, they weren't ready for it. Don't do that, by the way. Don't ever barrel roll next to a turret going after the Butcher. I thought I was going to push him off a little bit more than that, but to be a little bit more fair to myself, I was for sure, I thought that Dehaka was going to be able to read me. I should have pinged, though. So basically give up a free kill to the Butcher for basically nothing. I mean, we did kill him anyway, but Perky hounding the bot lane here. I think that might have been my first death. Yeah, my first death. There goes our immortal streak, unfortunately. Sorry, Falstad. And I mean, we're still just pancaking the enemy team. They're not able to get really any momentum here as the win streak sort of continues. Falstad. Oh, it's not off cooldown. Never mind. Just kidding. I apologize. We do get that reduced tailwind mobility help as well. So, sorry. I'm going to use Static Strike here on top of, or Lightning Rod rather, on top of the Shaman. Not going to give Kel'Thuzad free damage on myself. I prefer not. Whenever you're going up against an Avatar player, make sure you go for the one that is getting symbioted. Or hatted, as some people do say. I haven't really had to use my stacks of bribe all that much in this game so far. You see Avatar is in the smoke right there, but I'm not going to risk going after him, especially since we don't know where the Butcher is. Me and the Mercster are going to take the camp here. Somehow I didn't target the Shaman, even though I thought I had my mouse cursor. I'm pretty sure you heard me hit the key, too. Whatever. Alright, so I know where the Butcher is, so I don't have to worry about this. I also know that Abathur is somewhere in the smoke. There he is, right there. I was able to hit Abathur, but unfortunately, we don't have anyone over here. Except Nova, of course. Alright. From now on, I'm not going to assume that Murky or any one of my teammates are right next to me before I use the Mighty Gust. I don't know what part of my brain said that Murky was right next to me and I was going to use Mighty Gust into the March of the Murlocs. Don't ask. Don't ask and I won't tell. I mean, I will tell you because, you know, it was two really stupid deaths. Two deaths that could have easily been avoided had I just simply looked at the minimap. That's alright, 22-7 so far, dying two times very quick. After going immortal and being, you know, we're doing pretty good. Now it's starting to look like a fool with our pants on the ground sort of thing. Big damage there from the Sentry Owl by Tyrande. I do have flight up and I am going to fly over here behind them. No problem. Need to wait for Dahaka. I don't think I'm going to be able to get... I don't know if we have enough damage over here to really deal with this. I'm going to try anyway. I'm going to fly behind him. Here we go. Going to go right after Kel'Thuzad. I was able to take him out. Nice web wrap there by a new Barak. How many times is Butcher going to charge me? Apparently it's a whole lot. There's Tailwind. Tailwind actually helped me out. Then I get stunned by the freaking Punisher. Here comes Lightning Rod on Arthas. Able to take him out. There we go. Level 20 going to be going for Epic Mount, which is basically going to reduce the flight cooldown and the cast delay on flight. I see Nova is in the mid lane, so I don't feel too bad about hearthing right here. You should probably not do that. I'm going to hearth and get a little bit of help, or get a little bit of HP and mana back, then head right over here and start DPSing the boss. The boss really shouldn't be doing a whole lot of damage to us. It's only a frozen Punisher, and I'm pretty sure that just myself alone, I can take out the Punisher without really too many issues. Another nice thing about Falsad, of course, is that he can just kite endlessly. There we go. Yeah, so Epic Mount, basically, it's going to reduce the cooldown of flight by a whole lot. I mean, a whole lot. 30 seconds, and also it decreases the cast delay to a half second, meaning that as soon as I cast it, I'm going to be able to I'm going to be able to travel out and get wherever I need to be. There's Abathur right there, actually. Good job by Dahaka seeing that. Love to get another couple stacks here of Bribe. But we're getting 25% damage bonus here on our Lightning Rod right now. Thanks to our Bribe stacks. Good job there by Dahaka. The Butcher is not going to be able to self-heal out of that. Going to fly behind Arthas and push it back into our team. Ends up going for Army of the Dead here. Again, it's almost impossible to get away from Falstad. Unless you're Arthas and you have Army of the Dead up, of course. 2 seconds left on flight. I don't quite have Mighty Gust up off of cooldown yet, but it doesn't really matter. Down goes Arthas. Finally, we take him out. Also, is also very good at taking down Abathur Ness as well. So we are going to be able to get the win here. I wouldn't exactly say it was a difficult win. We were able to get some pretty decent team fights early on, and yeah, just steamroll the enemy team. Final total 29-9. I'll go ahead and leave this build down below. Let me know what you think of the Ride the Lightning build. And as always, I'll see you all next time for more Solo Q Silius. Until then, so long, everybody.